What's up guys, Lon here from Android Authority, and today we're taking a look at the Zenfone 5Z. This is a $500 flagship from ASUS, and that $500 is gonna get you a Snapdragon 845 processor, 6 gigabytes of RAM for the base model, 64 gigs of internal storage, a micro SD card slot, a fingerprint sensor, and it even comes with a headphone jack, which is always a good thing to see in 2018. Along with the headphone jack, you're also getting dual speakers that sound incredibly loud, and they get even louder if you turn on the outdoor mode, but it does sort of do this at the expense of low-end punch and bass. Now, the Zenfone 5Z was first unveiled at this year's MWC, which was a while ago, and my initial reaction, and probably the initial reaction of a lot of people, is that it looks like an iPhone X, and ASUS is not the only company that's guilty of making an iPhone X clone, but it's definitely something that you can't really get around when talking about the 5Z. The design looks exactly like the iPhone X, the camera placement and the orientation looks like the iPhone, and it even has a notch on the display like the iPhone, but the notch here is a little bit smaller because it doesn't have any of the extra Face ID sensors. It's just the earpiece and the front facing camera. I'm not the biggest fan of notches, but when a phone does have one, I just sort of embrace the fact that it's there. But if it really does bother you, you do have the option to hide it in the software. The screen is a 6.2 inch 19:9 display, and it goes nearly edge to edge. It's also 1080p with LCD technology, so it's not gonna have the same inky deep blacks as an OLED screen, but this is a really good looking LCD display. It's very colorful, very vibrant, and it also gets pretty bright that I didn't really have any issues seeing it outdoors. Of course, with a Snapdragon 845 processor and plenty of RAM, performance on this phone is very good. It's fast, it's fluid, apps are very quick to load, games are very smooth on this phone, and battery life on this phone is also extremely good. It's a 3300 milliamp hour battery, which isn't the largest battery in the world, but it's a pretty decent size, and I was averaging around 5 hours of screen on time, sometimes a little bit more, which is plenty to comfortably get through a full day. The software is Android 8.0 Oreo, which doesn't necessarily give me a ton of hope that this phone will get updated to Android Pie anytime soon, especially since it's shipping with an older version of Oreo out of the box. Now, on top of Oreo is ASUS's ZenUI, which is their own custom interface, and it's not necessarily my favorite. It's a little bit too cartoony, a little bit too colorful, but this is Android after all, so you can throw on a custom launcher and make it look a little more like stock Android if you want. Now, something that ASUS really touts with the software on here is a lot of the AI features, and I put AI in air quotes because a lot of the AI features on here, it's more of a marketing slash buzzword gimmick instead of actual AI. So for example, ASUS calls the screen an AI screen because it's able to stay on when you're looking at it, and it'll shut off if it detects that you're not looking at it. It also has a feature called AI ringtone, which will make the ringtone louder or quieter based on how loud your environment is. And the features do work as advertised, but I don't necessarily consider these actual AI features. They're features that we've seen before on other smartphones, and they weren't called AI before. On the back of the Zenfone 5Z is a 12 megapixel primary shooter with f1.8 aperture and a secondary 8 megapixel wide angle lens. And I'm really happy to see another smartphone with a wide angle secondary camera, because wide angle lenses are a ton of fun to use, especially for landscape shots and group photos. There is a little bit of barrel distortion along the edges, but it's very, very minor. Nothing that's really gonna mess with the quality of the images. And overall, it's a pretty decent camera. It takes really great photos in well-lit conditions with really natural and lifelike colors, plenty of detail, and surprisingly very good dynamic range. In low light, the images do come out a little bit softer than I would like, but it still does a pretty nice job of preserving colors and detail in the highlights. So for $500, the Zenfone 5Z is obviously priced very competitively to phones like the OnePlus 6. And overall, I think ASUS has a very solid package here. You're getting flagship specifications and a very high-end experience for only $500. And it undercuts a lot of the $700, $800 flagships and even the $1,000 flagships that we're seeing today. But the only thing that holds me back with the Zenfone 5Z is how often this phone is going to get software updates over its lifetime. Because at least with something like the OnePlus 6, you know that you're getting software updates pretty frequently, and it already has Android Pie in the form of a beta. So if you really care about software updates, the OnePlus 6 might be the better option. But if software updates aren't really that high up on your priority list, and you just really want a quality Android experience, the Zenfone 5Z is a pretty solid option that isn't going to break the bank. But that's really it for this review. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. If you did, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, hit that notification bell, which is down below, and check us out on social media. And also check out the website, androidauthority.com, because we are your source for all things Android.